Each week after publishing videos, I read thousands of comments and I reply to as many as possible. You guys give me some absolutely terrific video project ideas, and this is one of your ideas, so we're gonna do it. I had at least 200-300 people ask me to test brake parts cleaner. Will an engine run off of brake parts cleaner? And if so, what will happen to the engine? Is it gonna do damage to the engine? Is it gonna allow the engine to be cleaned up some? Will it work better than Marvel Mystery Oil, Seafoam, and B12 Chem Tool? These are just some of the questions that people have. Also, what does it look like burning through the see-through cylinder head engine? Will it look any different than gasoline? So, there's a lot of questions that remain unanswered, so let's go ahead and get this project underway and find some answers. I previously used this cylinder head in a test using paint thinner, and as a result, I ended up with a bunch of buildup on this cylinder head. I think the buildup occurred because a lot of the buildup that was on the piston and valves transferred over to the cylinder head. I went ahead and cleaned this spark plug up. I want to see what it looks like after running the brake parts cleaner through the engine, but I thought it would be best to start with a really clean spark plug. So I've got the MSDS for the brake parts cleaner. This is the non-chlorinated brake spark cleaner. I do not recommend burning anything that's chlorinated. It'll put off some nasty chemicals that you do not want to inhale. But this has 40 to 50% propanone, 20 to 30% dimethyl benzene, and then 20 to 30% of heptane. Anytime I'm testing chemicals, I want to know what the flash point is. And what's interesting here is it shows the flash point information is not available. It also shows that nothing's available regarding the evaporation rate or the flammability as a solid or a gas. It does show the initial boiling point and boiling range is somewhere around minus 109 degrees Fahrenheit or minus 78.5 Celsius. So this stuff is highly flammable. In a recent video, I added this see-through fuel tank assembly to this engine in order to just have a better view of what's going on. And so this is the fuel line running up to a funnel that's been JB welded to the bottom of this little tank. And so will brake parts cleaner destroy the JB weld? We're soon gonna find out just how durable JB weld is. But I just find it more interesting to be able to see what it is that we are using inside the fuel tank. So we're going to go ahead and add the brake parts cleaner now. Okay, the engine stalled out and it's just not going to restart unless I do something different. So one of two things is happening here. It's either dissolved some plastic components inside the carburetor, or this is a non-adjustable carburetor and I don't think the fuel air mix is right. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply a little bit of tape. This is some Gorilla tape to sort of restrict the flow a little bit, and I'll have to keep adjusting this until I get the right fuel air mix. But basically, it's like running the engine with a choke, and so we'll see if it'll run now. So the engine's still not wanting to run, so I'm going to go ahead and pinch off the fuel line. And then I'm going to take the bowl off and see if we've got any issues going on inside the carburetor. Okay, so I've removed the float and the gas is still not flowing, so we've got a restriction in here. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and take the fuel line off and run some compressed air, pushing it into the carburetor, and see if we can get some movement. So I had some sort of restriction inside the fuel line itself. I'm not sure if JD Weld's coming apart or if it's some part of plastic, but this stuff is highly corrosive. Fuel is now flowing. So I'm going to go ahead and put this all back together and see if we can get this engine fired up again. So this is a funnel that I have glued on to this container with JB Weld. As you can see, JB Weld held up just fine. I think the white gummy stuff, or the sort of yellowish gummy stuff that ended up inside the fuel line, was either buildup that was from inside this old fuel line, or else it was part of the funnel breaking free and getting into the fuel line, gumming it up. If you haven't seen a previous video, this engine's been set up to run on vapors. So this valve here controls the flow of vapors entering the engine. There is no gasoline going into the engine. This was the fuel line going to the fuel tank. As you can see, I've plugged it with the screw. Also, I did leave the carburetor on there. I want the throttle plate to regulate the RPMs of the engine, because if I ran straight vapors, then the engine could over rev and that might cause a problem. To explain how the engine runs off of vapors, these two tubes feed air into the container and they allow the oxygen to sort of bubble up to agitate whatever is in the container. And then the fumes or the vapors are sucked up into the engine through the hose into the engine, just the vapors with an oxygen mix. Brake parts cleaner is incredibly corrosive, and it didn't take long to ruin the carburetor on this small engine. Actually, I could repair the carburetor. I just have to order a rebuild kit and replace the rubber components. But just want to say thank you again to the many of you who asked me to do this project. I listen to each and every one of you. I read all your comments and try to reply to as many as possible. I get all my video ideas from you guys, so if you have more ideas, please leave a comment and I'll get to your ideas as quickly as possible. I hope you'll like, share, and subscribe if you haven't done so already. I'm also looking for your tips on how to make these videos more entertaining and educational, so I look forward to reading your comments on that as well. As usual, thank you very much for watching the video, and I look forward to seeing you next time.